The Upbeat Atheist. Upbeat Atheist here. Welcome back, friends. Did you ever hear anyone say, "Jesus died to set me free"? Turns out, I kind of agree with them. At least, when my belief in a mythical almighty God passed away, I was kind of reborn. My whole way of thinking changed. And you know, Jesus is just one of a pantheon of gods that have died, some ostensibly as a sacrifice, and some just the victims of human history. Do any of these names ring a supernatural bell for you? Me either. But they're all gods out of ancient history. Now take a look at this chart. It shows the oldest religions, Hinduism, Judaism, Buddhism, and now compare it to this chart. This chart is from Wikipedia, and it shows the predicted growth or decline in various religions up to the year 2050. The big winners seem to be my personal favorite, the nuns, or the religiously unaffiliated, and next is Islam, which is predicted to be the prominent religion worldwide by the year 2050. I wondered why Islam would experience so much growth. And there are a couple of things that come to mind, at least. One, the more vengeful the god, the greater the repercussions for disobedience. Then, the greater the adherence to the faith. And two, turns out, members of fundamental religious groups tend to have a lot more kids, so they can add members to the flock more easily than, say, Westerners or Europeans might, who have lower fertility rates. But if history repeats itself, Allah will one day go the way of his predecessors. Unfortunately, not likely we will be around to see that day. So, albeit a distant future, the future does seem bright. It seems like one day the need to believe in these man-made myths and the religions that go with them will fade away. And I hope once that happens, there are no young upstarts to come along and start a brand new religion. Ah, wouldn't that be nice? Imagine no religion. That's where the inspiration for the song came from. It's called "Gods Are Dying," and I hope you enjoy it.
Zeus hurled his last bolt of lightning ages ago, and wandering Odin at last made Valhalla his home. Quetzalcoatl, the feathered serpent, commanded the winds and the rain, gathered the bones of the ancient dead. Now his fate is the same, no life to reclaim. Ra had a good run as a noonday sun until he burned out, and the Old Testament bad guy Baal no longer about. New preserver, protector of all things, cannot save himself. He's destined to be just a tiny figurine, gathering dust on the shelf like everyone else. Gods are dying, dying to set us free. But there's no sacrifice in giving their lives for you and me. It's just that the end times have come for lifeless deities. And it's all for the best that they rest in peace. Killed Yahweh, so his followers say. Now Messiah is fading in favor, all things pass away. With all of his fervent believers, Allah holds on. Looks like he might be the last one. But when he's gone, we'll welcome the dawn. Gods are dying, dying to set us free. It's just like the scribes and the seers proclaimed that it would be. But they were blind to the twist in their own prophecy, that mere mortals would forsake their fables and fantasy. All God things must come to an end. With each one laid to rest, new life begins. We're our own blessed hope for the future, my friends. But until then, ready for the next demise. And when they meet their makers, oh, what a surprise. They will look us in the eyes.